Cue the fire. I have absolutely no good news for you today. Usually I know. I come bearing unicorns and sparkly dust. Cue the double fire today. Does it not remind you of that? That is just the commercial that came to my head. In today's video, we are talking about higher prices. Like 50% higher. I know, right? Just like I apologized yesterday. I didn't think inflation would be this bad. And I was clearly wrong. And the instability that it is going to bring currently the entire world. Because when people cannot get food, they get very mad. And I will show you the people around the world getting very mad. And it is coming home to roost. When I talk about coming home to roost, this whole system we are all part of, right? Like this. But one falls, another one falls, another one falls. Starts in Europe, Russia, ends up over here in the United States of America. And some people are like, oh, bravo, you're so crazy. Food prices, not even that bad. Really? Really? Have you not eaten lately? And I know I mentioned this last week, how German retailers are bumping prices 50%. And then my audience is like, well, I don't live in Germany. And the people that live in Germany are like, well, I do. And I lived there for 2 years. It hits home. And when I say hitting home, look at this. Look at this. Woo! Year over year inflation. That line just through the roof and keeps going. And even if I Google search it, German supermarkets increase food prices 20 to 50%. We got Aldi 20 to 50%. And coming in from the most trusted news in propaganda, CNN, from Pakistan to Peru, and riots, soaring food and fuel prices are tipping countries over the edge. And it always starts that way, just like this. In 2011, protesters, they hit the streets. But it's about freedom, but it's also about bread. It's about food. And if you ever want to know when the riots are going to start, well, it starts with an empty stomach. Oh, but bravo, that's over there. We'll never have riots in America. Huh? Start the timer. And the amount of things on this channel that you guys are like, oh, that'll never happen. Oh, hey, look, that's happening right now. Oh, well, that'll never happen. Oh my gosh, it's happening. Deadly protests in Peru as people take to the streets over what? High costs and inflation. And do you think it's going to get any better? Well, let's take a look. Russia, Ukraine. Do you think that's going to get any better? And I say no, especially if people are making money from it. My apologies. That's kind of how war is it's a money-making machine, and governments and businesses know, like, war on this, war on drugs, war on you, war on me, the war on a virus, right? Money to be made every single time. War in Ukraine may trigger severe world food crisis. May? No, has, now. Currently. But bravo, why can't I make money from all of this? Banks are making big money off of Russian. Everyone makes money except for us, right? Well, until I teach you how to, which I will show you in just a second. But before we do that, food prices are going up. You, right there, sitting there at your computer, and at levels Americans haven't seen in decades. Are you ready? That would be Malk. Lots of milk sitting there on shelves. And scrolling down towards the middle, not the bottom. They sell too much towards the bottom. Beef and veal up 16% this year. Pork, 14%. Poultry, everything up and away. Now, let me help you. I got to do a little drawing for those of you LA Unified. I know, I taught in it, so I have to do some tough math. If you're making $100,000 a year, that's what I was making as a teacher, $100,000 a year. That means I need to make 16% more, or 20%, because they're saying, well, then tack on another 5% for the rest of the year. You're looking at about 20%. 20% of 100,000, you got to make 120,000 a year just to break even. So my question to you is, are you now making 20% more? Oh, your rent? Oh, come on out here to Austin. rent only went up 40 or 50%. Are you now making 40 or 50% more in your rent? Are you making 20% more in your food? And if the answer you're saying is no, well, that means you have one or two or maybe seven options. One, you can move to California and they'll, you know, cut you an extra $1,000 a month if you, you know, qualify for whatever they decide. And then maybe another $1,000 a month or $500 because gasoline went up. So we got to take care of our people. But the only problem is when you do it on one end, the other end goes up. It's just, it always balances. It's just like when you go to the doctor and he's like, oh, you have high blood pressure. We got to put you on this one pill. It's a statin and that'll lower your blood pressure. Well, the only other problem is it lowers something else, but the same company that makes the blood pressure that they make for that thing that goes, doesn't work anymore. You see, whether it's economies or even your body, you can't, it always wants to balance. Same thing. You want to go on a diet, you starve yourself. It works, well, until it doesn't. Because the body doesn't like to lose anything. And it's like, whoa, what just happened here? And then it's like pulling a rubber band down and whoop, hey, I just gained more weight now. I guess maybe I shouldn't have went on that diet. But I'm trying to come up with some solutions. How are we gonna make an extra 20 grand? Well, you can do Uber Eats. You can get work more. You can marry more. I mean, you could get yourself five husbands and they can all pitch in, or five wives. Make them all do work, or you can sell this kind of stuff on Amazon. And I always do get nervous when I come here because you guys get to see. Do you want to buy it again? Do you want to keep shopping for owl poop, or do you want to pick up where we left off? See, as you guys know or don't know, I sell on Amazon, so I'm always researching. And just to let you know, that owl poop sells for, I don't know, the guy's making like 15, 20 grand a month. But what I was curious was this one, right? Food. Emergency food supply. How much are these guys making on a bag of 72-hour food? Well, I'm glad you ask. They make $100,000 a month, $100,000 a month, $100,000 a month, $45,000 a month, $351,000 a month, $400,000. I think that's pretty good. You see, you solve your problem and you solve other people's problems and you can go home and sleep well at night. Or you could just sell owl poop. Also, like what I've been telling you, my prices are going up on learning how to do that. See, dominate Amazon. I have a course on it for $1,000. But I forgot the click more. I forgot that one. But this is still up today. Just this weekend. Oh, it's Sunday. This is going to be gone. So if that 400 is gone for both of my courses, well, my apologies. That will teach you how to trade stocks. The one over there, all three courses for 197. Oh my gosh. That one's going too. Because I guess inflation affects all of us. Here's another thing about inflation. You can raise your, that's what people do. They're like, oh, sorry, we got to pass it along to the consumer. And I'll tell you, do you really think for a second that food giants are not, see, look, food giants expect to spend 50% more on meat ingredients. Oh, they're not going to pass it on to you. Yes, they are. Your costs are going to double. My apologies, that was terrible math. Not double. You got to wait one more year. Then it doubles. And then we have rioting in the streets. But right now, everything's just kind of A-OK, right? And I know you guys are hurting because I Googled it. Credit card spending as a whole increased almost 30%. You guys want to know why? Americans ramp up credit card spending. Return to the old. It's because you're now broke. They gave you the stimmies. You spent the stimmies. You maybe blew it in the stock market, lost it all in the stock market, and now we're here again. I mean, you guys aren't even ordering online anymore. Look at this. As food prices hit an all-time high, more Americans have abandoned online grocery shopping and returned to the supermarket aisles because you are broke. And I say, fix that. Fix that broke thing. Be like a bank. Make money off of all this. And how are the banking stocks doing? You guys, Bank of America? We good? Welp, the answer is no. You are underneath the blue line. That is your 200-day moving average. Coming down on the MACD. My apologies for your bank stocks. How about the rest of the stock market? Bitcoin flat, 42, 43. We got the Dow Jones Industrial Average underneath the 200-day moving average. That means bear market. And the Fed is going to continue until they can't, until they just wipe it all out like they do every single time. S&P 500 under, ooh, you're just sitting on that. Eh, give that little head and shoulders a couple minutes. It'll play out. Oh, there's your cues. That would be the NASDAQ underneath the 200. But how about the housing market, housing sector? Nope. No. Does anyone see all of this coming? Well, I do. And I think these yields will keep going higher and higher until they can't. So it just depends on what, actually, and then one of you guys threw out, you're like, bravo, Tyson, you emailed or in the comment section. I'm like, I will make that trade because I also have a watch list. Look at this. See this? See this falling wedge? I said, okay, not just that. Look, we're talking food, right? I said, when it breaks, it's going to go price target all the way up there. So thank you for that. And actually, it's really easy. Teach you guys all this in the course. This one was a swing trade. It's actually both. You take this one with the CSU. That was your measured move. You right click, look, you put in a little stop. This is so cool. I can slide it up. I can slide it down. So yay, we are up $3.79. And I'll even show you. I turn on my little indicators. Yep, in the course, see where it says buy, which was, I think, a little later on that one. And we just ride it all the way. But again, I do have a Bravo's watch list. Do not take that, though, until you know how to swing trade first. Then you move into, you know, this kind of stuff, because you need to make up for the shenanigans the governments do, that 20% or that 50%. And my apologies, but I'm always going to preach that forever and ever. I'm going to always preach, start a business. I don't care what it is, where it is, or when it is, it just needs to be started. And then once you're done with that, you learn how to trade equities, just like the rich do. And that is exactly why I taught it in high school, in college, on YouTube, because that is your only solution. Or just, again, like I said, marry five husbands or five wives or something. Some other kind of income. Because at the end of the day, you want to have some skin in the game and feel good when you make a product, right? I get it. Do you get it? I hope so. And I will see you in the next video.